Hi everybody, Natalie here with All Four Paws of West Palm Beach Dog Training and my very eager friend, Miss Maddie. Maddie and I are here to do something fun today and teach you how to teach your dog to discriminate their toys by name. So Maddie already knows Lamb Chop by name, and today we want to teach her Gator. So the way I'm going to do this is with positive reinforcement clicker training, which I have a couple videos explaining clicker training on my page if you're interested in learning more. And some good high value treats that I've got in my pouch here. So I'm just gonna start out by getting Maddie kind of interested in looking at or sniffing or touching Gator. Look. And then I'm gonna click and treat for that behavior. Oh, that was a big one. When she's done chewing, I'm gonna repeat this, go through it a bunch of times. Good girl. I'm not really asking for anything particularly, just trying to get her interested in this toy. So any interest at all, going over to it, sniffing it, anything like that's going to get a reward. This doesn't have a squeaker, makes it a little hard to get her excited about it. Yeah, there you go. Good girl. Good girl. Okay. Good girl. If your dog knows touch, if you've taught them that, that's a great way to get your dog interested in learning toys by name as well. They might be a little more inclined to make contact with a toy if they know that cue. Good girl. Okay, so Maddie's already picked up that I'm rewarding her for going over to this toy, so now she's offering me that without me even asking. So as you can see, Maddie's going over, standing on it, pawing it, touching it with her snout, so that's perfect. Good girl. So I'm gonna let Maddie go through a series of doing that and clicking and treating her for that behavior so she understands that I'm rewarding her for showing interest in that toy, making contact with it. Good girl. Now after Maddie does this reliably a bunch of times, which she's demonstrating now, she's continuing to go back over to the toy and touch it. I'm going to assign a verbal cue. So I'm gonna use the word gator to name this particular toy. So when she starts going over there and touching it, gator, I'm gonna start introducing that verbal cue. Gator, good girl. Gator, good girl. So I'm not gonna make this video too long. I'm gonna go through and probably do that about 20 more times to help her learn that name for that toy. And then I'm gonna come back and pick up where we left off. Okay, so Maddie and I ran through a bunch of practice where I basically just said, gator, good girl, gator. I was saying the word when she was almost at the toy and then saying it when she was making contact with it. And now I can say it and have her go over to it, gator, good girl, pretty reliably. Gator, good girl. Maddie, yes, gator. So she's doing this because many times in a row in succession, I have clicked and treated Maddie for that exact behavior, going over and making contact with the toy. So she's offering me what's been rewarded. She's not doing something else because this is what's getting her the prize. Yes, Maddie, gator. Good girl, gator. Yeah, good job. Gator, yes. Maddie, gator. Good girl. Maddie, gator. Good girl. So Maddie's really fast too. So I might try to reward for the times where she's staying at the gator a little bit longer before coming back over to me for a treat. Yes, good girl. Gator. Good girl. I don't want to make it too confusing though, so yes, good girl. Gator, good girl. Okay, and in order to proof this behavior so that you know for sure the dog knows the difference between gator and lamb chop, you've got to change it up a little. Dogs don't generalize well, so I'm gonna switch the places of these toys and start again and see if she understands. So Maddie Gator. Yes, good girl. Maddie. So I'm not using the word now until she goes over to the other one. Gator. Because if I say the word gator when she goes to lamb chop, it makes it a little confusing. So you have to be pretty good with your timing here. Gator. Good girl. Gator. So she offered going over to lamb chop maybe two or three times. And because there was no reward for that, there was no food motivation for that, she quickly stopped offering that behavior. Gator. Good girl. Good job. Maddie. Gator. Good girl. Now she is, you know, going over there many times. I'm waiting for her to kind of settle down just a little bit so I can use the word to send her over there. Maddie. Maddie. Gator. Good girl. Gator. Good girl. So you would continue to prove the behavior. You can introduce a second toy to change out with this one. Move positions again. You can have a third toy available. And continue to use the toy's name and click and treat for the dog going over and showing interest. Yes, good girl. Gator, good girl. And that's basically the gist of it. That's how you teach your dog to learn a toy by name. And it's something really fun that you can do, especially once you teach your dog a lot of different toy names. It's a great rainy day game, a great activity for inside if it's too hot out. And it's just something fun to do with your dog. It will get them very tired. It involves quite a bit of thinking. Maddie, Gator, yeah, good girl. Maddie, Gator, good job. And I always like to end on a good note. So I'll ask Maddie to do it one more time. I'll jackpot her, which means give her lots of treats, and then call it a day. Keep it light and fun. Make sure to give your dog lots of great treats that they're happy to work for and praise. And have fun with it. So happy training, everyone. Maddie, Gator. Get the Gator. Get the Gator. Whoops. Maddie, get the Gator. Yay! Good job, Maddie. You're so smart. Good girl. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Make sure to give me a thumbs up if you liked this video. Share it, subscribe, and keep tuning in for more good stuff.